Hey devs, welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new to this channel, I invite you to subscribe and join us. Hit the subscribe button and click bell icon. Scroll to top is a common practice for most websites. It appears as a clickable icon at the bottom or footer of websites. Clicking it scrolls the page to the top. It is helpful in accessibility, and website viewer can quickly navigate to top of page without using page scroll bar. It is used so widely and for almost every website. Let's build our own scroll to top functionality that will scroll smoothly to the top. We will use jQuery and jQuery easing library to build it. I've got this HTML page, and this is the CDN.js. You can go to cdnjs.com and get the assets from here, like jQuery Bootstrap and jQuery Easing plugin. And I have got this HTML document that has got Bootstrap CSS, Twitter Bootstrap CSS, and it's got font awesome linked via cdn.js, and I've got custom.css. Let me correct the path, and I've got custom.js. This is the custom.scss that will be converted into custom.css, and this is custom.js in same folder, and I have linked the jQuery also from cdn.js. I need another script that is jQuery easing from cdn.js, and I will need jQuery easing main.js. Copy script tag and I will paste it here, and I will use defer with it as well. And so this is our page. Let's right click inspect and see if there are any errors. Custom.css is not found. Custom.css, alright, so let's create the custom.css file, and let's save this custom.scss file, and I've got custom.css now, and let's refresh the page, and there are no errors now. Okay, so we want this page to scroll, and we want some kind of control or icon at the bottom, and we will click at that icon, and then page will be scrolled to top smoothly. So for that we need a scroll. This is our HTML page, and simple container, a heading and a paragraph. So we will add some extra space here by using style height 2000 pixels, and then we will need our icon in the footer, and here we will have an anchor link. Let's give it a class top and text center, and then let's use an icon, font awesome icon from font awesome, fa dash angle dash up, and then fa dash fw. So this is our simple link containing an icon from font awesome. This is our footer, and let's use some space below as well, 400 pixels. So this is our page now, and we have got the icon. Where is the icon? This is the icon. Let's style this area footer. So this is our custom.css file, and here we will have footer, and for footer we want some padding, and then we want some background color, and then top. This is the anchor, this one top. So cursor pointer and display block, and then it has got icon inside it, and we want to increase the icon size. Let's use 30px or let's use 40px. So this is our CSS. Let's see what we've got now. This one, alright, clicking this will jump the page like that. We don't want that. We want to scroll it to top. So color black. Okay, so this is our icon area that will move the document to the top, and our scroll is in place. And now we will need to write the script for functionality. Essentially, we will need to write the functionality for this icon. So let's write a function. First of all, function move to top, and then it will contain, this is the function, right? So it will have the logic. So jQuery class top dot click function. So when this class top will be clicked, we want the document to scroll, right? And also we want to prevent default the anchor's default behavior. E dot prevent default, and then we will use again the jQuery, and then body dot animate, and then here scroll top 0. So this is our function, but this function is not being used, and we can test it. And let's refresh the page, and let's paste that function here, and let's run it, and let's come down here and try the function again. Undefined, move to top, undefined. So this is a custom.js, and we have linked the custom.js file here. So let's use document.ready. Document.ready function, and inside it let's trigger move to top. Okay, so click at the top and then move body to the top. Animate body to top. right? Still not working. So console.log, hello world. So hello world is there, so that means our custom.js is being used. Now this is the function and it is not working. Why? So let's use HTML with the body as well. And now this is working. Click and it moves to the top, but it is not smooth. As you can see, this is not smooth. Okay, so if we remove the body, what will happen then? Refresh and click at the page and it is working. So you don't need body, you need HTML. HTML will work here. Fine. All right, so this is not smooth. We want to move it smoothly, so we will use this library, jQuery easing library. But before that, let's add some time here. 800 milliseconds and let's see what happens. Click. It's a little bit better. If we increase time, let's say 2000, refresh the page and click, it is really slow. Okay, so I guess 800 is fine. 800 or 500 is fine. And now let's use some function from jQuery easing. Ease in out expo. Refresh. And now let's click it. So this is smooth now. Click. This is smooth now. So jQuery easing, this is jQuery easing plugin, and from here you can see the transitions, the functions available for different transitions. So you can come at easing.net, easings.net, easing functions. You can search for jQuery easing cheat sheet and it will bring you to this page. And here you can see is in sign and is in, is out sign, is in out sign, is in chord, is out chord. So is out chord, it starts faster and then ends slowly, and is in out chord, and is in cubic, and ease out cubic, ease out cubic. Let's use ease out cubic. Ease out cubic. And let's refresh the page and let's see. And let's tweak it a bit. Refresh. And click. All right, ease out expo, ease out expo. And personally I like this one, ease out expo. Animate to top. So this is our script. You need jQuery, and then you need jQuery easing plugin that you can get from here, cdn.js, and then you can have an idea about the type of animation from here, and then you can use this function in the custom.js when you will be animating the document. So at click of the class dot top, the document will animate to top smoothly. Refresh the page once more and click here. And so as you can see, we have a working scroll to top functionality ready to use. We can just use this code in our JS file, this one, for the website that we want this functionality in, and then you can call this function inside document.ready, and this function will work fine. Little bit of CSS, really useful function to add a smooth scroll to your page. Let me remove this extra space, and let's add these paragraphs here to show you this effect in a little bit detail. So this is much better. So that's it for me, guys. I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything or you have something to add, you can comment down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.